If you haven't already watched the simple user form screencast, I would encourage you to do that because this builds upon some of the concepts that I introduced in that screencast. What we're trying to do here is use inputs from multiple user forms in a calculation. So we're maybe subcontracting out to get different values from different user forms, and we're going to use those values in a central calculation. We want to make a user form that will have different buttons. When you press A, it opens up a secondary user form where the user can enter A, and then when they press submit, it basically closes this down, returns that value of A back to the main form. We can then click B, brings up another box where they can enter B. B is then returned to the main user form. Then we can press calculate, and a message box will come up saying the product is whatever. And then we can press OK or submit, and that form will disappear. We can reset, which will clean everything out, and we can quit, which will make the entire user form disappear. So I've got this already set up in the Visual Basic Editor. I've got five different buttons here. I've got a button Get A, and I've named that A button. I have Get B, which is B button, Calculate button, Quit button, and the Reset button. Let's first take care of the Get A, Get B, Quit, and Reset. I've already created two more user forms. So one is when they press Get A, we want this form to pop up. So the user can input A. I've named this text field A value. And then I have a Return from A button. After they input the value into A, they can click that. It'll then go back to the main user form. When they click B here, it'll open up this B user form or user form 3. They can input the B value. And then there's also a button here where it submits and returns to the main user form. And this is called Return from B button. So let's go back to the main one. Get A, we can double click on this. And when we do that, it brings up this private sub A button click. When they press the A button, we want user form to show. User form 2.show. We can do the same thing. Go back here to user form 1, get B. That's going to open up user form 3.show. Another thing I have to do is go into my user form 2 and user form 3, and we actually have to code what will happen when the user submits this user form. So I can double click on here. And all I'm gonna do is say user form 2.hide. Now we don't wanna use the unload user form 2 because that will actually erase the value that we just put in there. So, and I do the same thing for user form 3 where I put a user form 3.hide. Now we've set up the get A, the get B button. We need a quit button. We will write unload user form 1. Unload removes all the values that the user has input and then also basically hides it. So our reset button we can put in here. This is going to be unload user form 2 and unload user form 3. So what that will do is when we press the reset button, the values that we've previously put into 2 and 3 will be erased. If we don't have this reset button, if we reopen the get A and the get B user form, so user form 2 and 3, those values that we've previously entered will still be in there. So the last thing we have to deal with is this calculate button. So I've put in the code here for our private sub calculate button. There's a couple ways to do this, but I've dimmed product here, which is going to be a local variable as a single. So the product is going to be equal to user form 2.a value. Now this is something different than the previous screencast on the simple user forms. Because the A value is not a variable that's local to user form 1. So if I left out this user form 2, it would not recognize A value. So I have to put in the object user form 2, so then it knows to look in user form 2 for that A value. So it's looking for whatever I enter here. I can multiply user form A 2.A value by user form 3.B value. And then I'm going to have a message box that says the product is whatever. So everything's pretty much set up now. You can't just run a user form. You actually need to insert a module. So I'm going to insert a module to actually run this. So I'm going to do sub go product, and the only code I'm going to have in here is userform1.show. And then one last thing, I'm just going to go back to Excel. So I'm going to insert a button. It's going to run go product. Let's see if it works. I press go. It brings up our user form 1. I press get A, put 5, submit and return, get B. Let's say I put a 4, submit and return. And then I can do calculate, and it says the product is 20. And then I can reset everything. So then when I go back here, let's say I put a 6 and a 3, calculate the product, it's 18. You'll notice that if I go back into get A, the previous value is 6 there because I haven't reset, and I can keep going or I can quit, which shuts everything down.